Konnichiwa, hello. Welcome to the Nupur Tewari show, episode number 12. And this show is presented by Healindya and Healindya. And today's guest, you know that, right? It's very special musical evening it's going to be. Yes, she's Padma Sri awardee. She's gorgeous lady. She's the first Ghazal singer from Parsi community. So with big applause, let's welcome Miss Penaz Masani.
Namaskar. Welcome to Japan for the third time.
Oh, that's wonderful. It's lovely to be back virtually though.
Exactly. This is virtually, but would love to have you again here for the third time, you know, as a person, in person, definitely.
God is great. Yes, in better times, I will be back in Japan.
Definitely. So, like the first question, because I'm a woman and you are a woman as well. So, how do you keep yourself so beautiful? You look like you're 25 still.
That's very sweet of you, Nupur. Thank you for the compliment. Well, if you feel I'm beautiful, I think I'm a very simple girl. I think simplicity in itself is beauty. Being happy in your own space is beauty. Being comfortable and a little bit, it has to do with my genes, because my mom was a very, very beautiful lady, and my papa was tall and handsome. And the rest is good thoughts, our Zoroastrian principles of good thoughts, good deeds, good words. Good thoughts, good words, good deeds. So, and a healthy exercise pattern, and generally a simplistic way of living.
That's wonderful. Definitely, that's wonderful. But now, since we all know you for your music, we'd love to know where it started and how it started.
Nupur, my father hailed from Baroda, which was a small princely town in Gujarat. Yeah. And he was very fond of classical music. So he took up the discipleship from Aftabe Mausiqi Ustad Fayyaz Khan Sahab, who was the court musician in the court of Siyajirao Gaikwad, who was the Maharaja. Time of 1930s. So can you imagine the princely court and daddy accompanying Ustad Fayyaz Khan Sahab on the Tanpura before the Maharaja? So I think I got the liking of music from my genes, which is from my father. And then I started learning classical music from the Agra Gharana, from Ustad Amanat Khan Sahab. And then I met in one of the music competitions, a judge who was one of India's most renowned and most prominent and wonderful music directors, called Jaydev Ji. We've heard so many of his compositions: Allah Tero Naam, Ishwar Tero Naam, Abhi Na Jao Chhod Ke Ke Dil Abhi Bharan. So Jaydev Ji was very happy when he saw me in that competition, and incidentally, I won the first prize. The name of that competition was Sur Singar Samsar. And when he wanted a young budding singer for one of his television programs, he thought of me. So that's how I started visiting Jaydev Ji's home, which was at Churchgate Lily Court. And I was in Sydenham College of Commerce, which was just nearby. And I did so for a year. And then Jaydev Ji said, I really want you to learn further. That is how I got introduced to India's most finest, world's most finest musicians, Be Misal Fankara, Madhurani Ji. And when I met Madhurani Ji, I met Ghazal. And the rest is all before you.
Exactly. So that is that. And they're the responsible that we got you. And you're so many, you know, beautiful creation we have with us. You're, you know, they gave you to us. So we are thankful to them. We are grateful to them. So how music changed your life? Like, have you ever thought, like, you're from the Parsi community, and Parsi community, mostly they are not into, mostly into business. not into much into music. So have you ever, because yes, your father was into music, that was the biggest influence, but as a little girl, you thought having a career in music or something else?
No, Parsis were into a lot of dramatic, like Sora Modi in mm-hmm. the Evergreen Pictures yesteryears, and then we had Zubin Mehta, who's a Parsi and heading yes. the Philharmonic. And then we had artists like Zareen Daruwala, who is one of the ace sarodists and a wonderful musician. So Parsis have, but not so much in Ghazal. In fact, nothing in Ghazal. Because exactly. Ghazal involves Urdu, it involves the dialect. So I think I was the only one in that field. So right from the beginning, I was interested in music. I used to sing in class to keep the students quiet when I was a child. And I was very fond of dramatics. I loved the stage right from childhood. I was a bright student. So, you know, one thing led to another. What happened is that Jayadevji called me for Madhuji composed a beautiful ghazal for me for Doordarshan. So I sang that. And the next day, Polydor, that is Universal Records, came to me to sign a contract. That's how I cut my first album, Aapki Bazam Mein Penaz Masani. And television had already happened to me in the late 79 during black and white television. And because I looked a little different from the other singers, my curly hair was very thin. So I was popular on television. So, you know, the rasta khud ba khud ban gaya.
Exactly. As you said, God is great. So he had planned for you. So that happened. So yes, so as you said, you looked different and curly hair. So you never thought of having your career in acting, because you're so close to music industry and the Bollywood acting industry, movie industry, very close, you know, they go hand in hand.
Nupur, you know, I recorded a song for Dev Anandji for a film called Anandarana. And you know, Dev Sahab and his usual wonderful way of talking. He said, Penaz, I wanted to do a acting test. I forgot what it's called. So I did a screen test.
Okay.
Then I did a few serials. I acted in serials for Indian television. Mm-hmm. But when my father came to know about my interest in films, he was deeply saddened. Because he says that you can't do so many things at the same time. कहते हैं ना हिंदी में दो नाव पे दो कश्ती पे या दो नाव पे आप पैर नहीं रख सकते डूब जाएंगे आप. So after you do music, which is wonderful, and I'm not interested that you join films. So that's how I stuck to music, and thank God I did, because I'm whatever I did, I did through this beautiful realm of Ghazals.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, that was beautiful. You chose the right path. मतलब भगवान ने आपको पूरी तरह अच्छा जहाँ पे जाना चाहिए वही रास्ता दिखाया, है ना?
हाँ.
Exactly. So you just think that was the right choice. That you took the right choice.
Absolutely. I am very happy that I stuck to my music. I first started as a playback singer. I sang for a few films for Bhakti Lehri, Devanand. For one South Indian movie with Dr. Balamuli Krishna, and then I went into ghazals, and then there was no looking back. Then ghazal became my stage, and I was a princess on that stage.
Exactly. So now, when your time and today's ghazal, so what are the differences? Like, what difference do you find?
See, ghazal is a beautiful form of. It's a culture. Zindagi ka dusra naam hai. It's our culture. It's in our tapestry. So, ghazal as a form of art will stay on forever. But fashions come and go. So, in the 80s, ghazal was a fashion. Everybody wanted to be a ghazal singer. Everybody wanted to wear a sari and wear diamonds. They wanted to go to five-star hotels and see programs. And everybody jumped onto the bandwagon to make money. And naturally, it became a little difficult, and it started receding a bit when it came to year 2000. And but then again now, people have realized the importance of soft music on the nerves. It's a de-stress. The poetry is beautiful. The poetry is what we experience in life. That is the essence of ghazal, is what we are. Poets write about things they've experienced. Mirza Ghalib was during the time of the last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar. So he has seen those times. So that is how he's written about ghazals in that period, which was 1830 to 1847, about what Delhi was and what it became. Bahadur Shah Zafar wrote poetry when he was exiled to Myanmar. Ki lagta nahi hai dil mera ujde diyar mein. So what is ghazal? It's the portrayal of what life and times are. Now today, ghazals, in order to appeal to the masses and not to the kings who knew a lot of Persian and Urdu, it's become simpler. It's more to the masses. So you have simple ghazals like Aankh jab band kiya karte hain. सामने आप हुआ करते हैं, so that everybody likes it, and college boys can you know, visualize their girlfriends. So, you know, ghazal has become life for life's sake and not just life for art's sake.
Definitely. आजकल के movies में, these days movies, they, I don't see that many ghazals they are using. What do you think?
Because, again, Nupur, films is what is a portrayal of the times we are in. Now, the times we are in is not really the Mughal dynasty or the times in 1920 where there was Pardadari. So naturally today it's more westernized. So there is very, very little scope of showing, of portraying a ghazal. We do have a few films which care and shine, like Jogra Akbar or Fana or like that, but few and far between. There is no scope of having a soft ghazal. Huh? That's why today in films you have different kinds of music.
Exactly. लेकिन हमें चाहिए ना वो ghazal के जो touch, जिससे मतलब वो बस दिल को छू जाए. सुनते ही हम आप, you know, just stop.
That's what we are. We artists then have our own albums. I've released 28 albums till now. And we do a lot of shows. So I suppose we try to, you know, we had artists like Begum Akbar Sahiba, Madhurani Ji, Farida Khanum Ji, who have sung ghazals and have kept Mehndi Hassan Sahab, Ghulam Ali Ji, who have kept the ghazal live. And in our country, we have so many ghazal singers too. Pankaj Das Ji, Anup Jalota, Talat Aziz. So there's so many who keep the tradition alive.
Exactly. So now, definitely, you know, since the country we live in, we are very much aware about the what is happening around. So today's when you worked very closely with Bollywood or Hindi film industry, and today when you see the Hindi film industry, are they different? The work culture is different. Like you just talked about the Devanam Saab, he just said, "Keep it now, tumko to ye karna hai, screen test dena hai." You know, just the way people used to work, and today the way they work, are they different?
Today, no. Today, the youngsters of today are also very, very. It's become more regimented. It's become better. They're more hardworking. When you say 10 o'clock, it means 10 o'clock, which was very much prevalent in the south. And there were very few music directors like Opie Nayyar Sahab that used to be very time bound. When you say 10 o'clock, he would wait for 10 minutes. And if nobody comes, he would start with whatever he has. So today, I think the youngsters are very, very, kehte na bahut zaheen hai, aaj ke bache, aaj ke ladke, ladkiyan. They are more regimented. They look after their fitness freaks. So things have changed. But there is a bit of restlessness, which I think was not there earlier. In the earlier heroines were much more. And yes, the culture was different. This culture we are in is very different. I think today's generation is much more stressed.
Exactly, today's generation. And you can see that definitely you were in Mumbai and you were very closely with the Hindi film industry. And you see that we lost one actor also. As you say, today's generation is very much stressed. So what kind of things we have to do? Like today, a lot of complaints are coming. A lot of nepotisms are happening. A lot of groupism are happening.
For any, not only in films, for anything, for life, in order to have a healthy life, you have to change your lifestyle. Whether it's an actress, singer, RJ, or a company, or MD of a company, have a healthy lifestyle. Take out some time for yourself. Do a little bit of meditation. It's not easy, but try and look within. Now you have so much of time with lockdown. In India, you can definitely have time to look within because you can't go out. And you can... try and do a lot of, listen to a little music and do a lot of exercises, do yoga. So all this can really help to strengthen your lifestyle. Try and be honest and, honest to yourself and less stressed out. And these are because the mind is like a machine. It's a very... it sends out all the good and bad signals which affect the heart and different parts of organs of the body. So it's very important to try and control your mind, to think good, to be more relaxed. It's not easy. We all have deadlines. Even I have a deadline now. So, and you have a deadline. But try and live for yourself. How much will you live for others all the time? Try and have targets. You must have a target in life, but achievable targets. And there is no question of killing yourself and stressing yourself to attain a goal. It's not worth it. Life is too beautiful for all.
Exactly. Wonderful, wonderful. Now the next question is, you already visited and performed in Japan twice. So you'd love to know the experience. How was the experience and which year was it?
Oh, This was, oh my gosh, this was, I think, 2006, 2008, and then it was 2015. So 2008 was through the Ministry of External Affairs, through ICCR, Indian Council for Cultural Relations. I went to Tokyo and Kobe and Kyoto and did lots of shows. And what lovely audiences, what audiences. Then I went to Fukushima in 2015. Mr. Hasegawa, who is so much an Indian at heart, he had invited me. He had done a lot of shows say hi to him from me if he's listening. And
yes.
And you know, the discipline which you all have in Japan on stage, backstage, there was ghazals I was singing. So before that, I explained the meanings from India and they had it on the backdrop in Japanese. Then even the light, they would be so particular about as what is the sentiment of the ghazal, then they would change the lights. Like even you today, we've 15 minutes, we're deciding whether I should go left or whether I should go right, so we have the correct picture. So I think you are very disciplined and very particular about things. There's a lot of respect for senior citizens in your country. I've seen that. A lot of respect. And you bow down and you're so humble. And I love Japanese food.
Wow.
And teppanyaki, and I love all that. And it's very pretty. I love the Kyoto is such a pretty town. And the cherry blossoms. I had a wonderful experience in Japan, and I really want to come back again sometime.
Definitely. After the corona, we have to say pray that goes as soon as possible so we can have you. Yeah. So as I said, my country, this is actually meri karam bhumi hai, mera janam bhumi to Bharat hi hai, India hi hai. So definitely. But
Japanese lagne lage.
Log wahi bolte hain.
Bahut sweet lag rahe hain. Bilkul.
मतलब वही बोलता है लोग कि आप तो जापानीज हो, आप हाफ हो क्या? मतलब नहीं नहीं, मैं पूरी तरह इंडियन ही हूँ. एक्चुअली मुझे बहुत सुनना पड़ता है, हर दिन के, हर रोज की जिंदगी में सुनना पड़ता है कि मैं जापानीज जैसे दिखती हूँ. तो इसमें आपको मतलब जो आप मतलब थ्री थिंग्स जो आपने नहीं किया और करने का तमन्ना है, जो व्हाट यू रियली वांट टू डू यू कुड नॉट डू फॉर समथिंग, व्हाट दैट थ्री थिंग्स वुड बी?
आई थिंक इट द एंटायर पाथ इज ऑल लेड आउट. सो आई डोंट फील दैट आई वुड हैव लव्ड टू डू दिस एंड आई हैवंट डन इट. व्हाटएवर आई एम डेस्टिन्ड टू डू आई हैव डन. बट वेल दैट्स अ डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन. I have not done bungee jumping.
Oh, okay. And do you want to do that? You
want to
do that?
I don't really want to do it, but I want to experience what it is to experience fear.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You can control your nerves, mm-hmm. right? And secondly, I have been very fortunate to have been awarded the Padma Shri Award by the government of India.
Yes.
So that I have achieved. Maybe I achieve the Padma Bhushan. And thirdly is, well, I just want to thank God for everything He's given to me. It's very unfair because He's given me everything. Very loving parents, wonderful teacher, my Madhurani ji. So there's nothing really much that I would wish for. I just want to go on singing further. That's my wish. My wish is that till the end of my life, if I can sing, I would be very, very good. That's all I ask for.
And our good wishes, definitely. And God is there. And maybe you are on your way to get the Padma Bhushan. Yes, you definitely deserve it. Yes. So now, what new songs we can expect from you? The new album.
New albums are not happening anymore in India, Nupur, because the companies have changed. We used to take on an album every year. So now it's just songs. So I did a song recently for COVID, all the artists came together and we recorded a song. It was beautifully composed by Dr. L. Subramanian. So that was something new we did. Then I took out a song on the against female feticide titled Beti. It was written by Nida Fazli and composed by Shantanu Mitra. It was on the girl child. Like, it goes like, Saanso mein preet bhare, raago mein geet bhare, sapno mein rang bhare beti, Lakshmi ka deep jale, aarti ka shank baje, jis ghar mein vaas kare beti. So this is a song on the girl child. So,
क्या बात है, क्या बात है. इसमें मतलब सुन के ही लग रहा है कि दिल को छू लिया ऑलरेडी. मतलब यही हमें चाहिए, ये गजल हम इन दिनों मिस कर रहे हैं, जो आपसे हम सुनना चाहते हैं. तो पिनाज जी, अब हम रैपिड फायर की तरफ जाएंगे और आपसे कुछ क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे. वन सीक्रेट ऑफ योर्स विच यू नेवर रिवील्ड. okay. So, what's your biggest insecurity?
My biggest insecurity is, I hope I can sing forever. What happens if something happens to my voice?
कुछ नहीं होगा. Thank you. Your favorite food?
Your favorite
food?
Yakhani biryani.
Okay, and that is available everywhere?
Lucknow, in India.
Lucknow ke biryani. Okay, great. I have never been to Lucknow, so I'm not very used to with that. Okay, so your favorite person in your life?
Madhurani ji, my guru, my inspiration, and of course, my parents, but my father. I love my father. I love him and he's with me even today. Though he's not here in this world, but my father, Dolly Rustamji Masani.
But he is with you. His energy, yeah. His spirit is definitely with you. Yes. Your favorite destination?
Ladakh. That is Leh Ladakh in India. It's just awesome. It's beautiful.
So for everyone, for whoever is watching, you should definitely go to Ladakh. And
it's beautiful.
Okay, your favorite book, if you have any?
The Last Mughal Emperor by William Dalrymple.
Your favorite politician, if you have any?
No. Favorite politicians, Mahatma Gandhiji.
Okay, and present time, do you have any?
Present time, they're all so good.
All your favorites. Okay, your favorite attire, outfit?
Salwar kameez. Though I'm a Parsi, but I want to change that. Sari.
Okay.
Sari.
So Parsis, you wear the very different Gujarati style of sari, right?
Yeah, but I like the Indian style.
Normal style. Okay, very good. So describe in one word these people or things. Music in one word.
Life.
Your Guruji.
Divine.
And I'm going to a little bit politics. Modi ji. Our Prime Minister.
Prime Minister. Powerful.
And I'm sure you do watch TV. Our Arnab Goswami.
Arnab Goswami. I've got lots of youngsters in front now. How do I describe him in one word? India wants to know. Talkative.
India wants to know.
Okay.
Talkative.
Next is, in one word,
politics.
Dirty.
Hindi movies.
Mughalism.
And Kangana Ranaut.
Kangana. Gutsy.
Salman Khan.
Salman Khan? Fitness freak.
Yeah. Okay. And at last, we would like to know, like today, those who really want to pursue their career in Ghazal, what would be your advice for them?
Get to a great teacher, whoever you can find in your vicinity. You must learn classical music because that is the foundation to any other form of music you take up. And just learn music for the art. Don't try and make it into a profession because then you'll get it all mixed up. Let things flow and things will fall into place. Respect your parents, respect your teacher, and try and be a good person. It'll help you in your art.
Exactly. I think that should be the fundamental thing, to be a good person. Yes. If you are a good person, you will find good persons around you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Penaz. It was a pleasure having you. Thank you so much. We'll be waiting to have you in Japan.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Nupur. All the best.
Healindya, and our guest was very gorgeous Padmasri Miss Penaz Masani. Next Saturday, I'll be back with another dynamic guest. Same time, same place. Before that, please don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, Yoganda Nupur. You'll find all the episodes there. And we are everywhere. We are on Twitter, on Instagram, and definitely on Facebook. Please do like our pages, do follow us. Your support means a lot to us. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself and love yourself too. Subratri, West Minasai, good night. Namaste.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.